Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club, and thank you for coming out on such a cold, wintry day. I know the last 2 weeks, I don't know if it was a bad joke or if some people are laughing all the way to the polls, but today we have a very different sort of event after you know, several weeks of politics, and we still have more probably political speakers coming up, but we're actually having something a bit different today. As any of you know who've watched Japanese TV, you've probably seen this company's entertainers, comedians, musicians, if you've watched any Japanese TV. And today we have two speakers. First, we have the head of Yoshimoto Kogyo, Mr. Hiroshi Osaki, right here. And then we have another speaker, Ms. Shizuko Yokote. She's the president of MCIP Holdings, which is a company that was set up with Yoshimoto, Dentsu, Sony Music Entertainment, Ian Mall, Duango, and some other companies, and also a government-backed Cool Japan Fund. And so today, our first guest speaker will talk about the company Yoshimoto Kogyo, a bit of their history, their background, what their business is, and why they're trying to expand more internationally. And to get into some of the more specifics, the second speaker, Ms. Yokote, will talk about MCIP, which I believe stands for Media Contents Integration Project. And they're focusing quite a bit on Southeast Asia to try to export the Japanese entertainment business and also the model. And Yoshimoto Kogyo, and they both have said that, I mean, when you think of Cool Japan, you usually think of anime and manga and maybe sushi and sake, but it's a bit more than that. And so anyway, without any further ado, I'd like to introduce our first guest, the president and CEO of Yoshimoto Kogyo, Mr. Hiroshi Osaki. And I also forgot, on the far left is our usual interpreter, and she will be handling the interpretation today. Thank you.
あ、そうですか。これは取ってもらって大丈夫です。あ、すみません。吉本興業の大崎博士と申します。本日はお招きいただき、こういう機会を与えていただきまして、 感謝いたしております。私どもは6年ほど前から沖縄で沖縄国際映画祭というものをしております。また今年秋に京都で京都国際映画祭というのを始めました。その折には多大なるご協力をいただきました。常日頃から皆様方には
Hello, I've just been introduced. My name is Hiroshi Osaki, and I am the head of Yoshimoto Kogyo. As many of you may know, first of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you so very much for this kind invitation to speak before you today. As many of you may know, 6 years ago, we launched in Okinawa an international movie or film festival. And this autumn in Kyoto, we launched a similar international film festival. For both of these film festivals, we have received a great deal of support from the foreign press. We are very, very grateful. And we also thank you for your support on a daily basis as well. Thank you.
あの、今もたくさんのカメラの写真を撮っていただいたんですけれども、私が社長になった6年ほど前に、フライデーという雑誌に6週連続撮られたのを今鮮やかにというか蘇りました。
It's very interesting. A few moments ago, many photographers were before me taking my photograph, and I suddenly had a feeling of deja vu. I remembered a time when 6 years ago I first became president of Yoshimoto Kogyo, and at that time there was a scandal magazine called Friday, and for 6 weeks I was featured on this magazine, and I was always surrounded by reporters. I suddenly remembered that time again.
まあ、吉本興業は大阪で生まれ育ちまして、今年で102年の 会社です。まあ、そういう意味では100年続いた興行の会社なので、良くも悪くもそういう檻というか、いろんなものがこう溜まってたのだと思います。
As you may know, Yoshimoto Kogyo has a very long history. We were born and raised, established, and began and grew our business in Osaka. We have a history of over 102 years. And so when you have been in business in the entertainment world for over a century, you have many, many wonderful things in your history, and you have many, many not so wonderful things in your history. That is simply life.
35年ほど前に Yoshimoto Kogyo という会社に学校出て入りました。そしてしばらくをして、今の大阪にあるナンバーグランド花月という当社の劇場をリニューアルして新しく建てました。その時に、3ヶ月のロングランの興行を2つやりました。1つはアメリカンバラエティ版というタイトルで、それまでのアメリカのブロードウェイのミュージカルの名場面を再現したようなショーです。もう一つは舶来寄せという、世界中のバラエティアクト、芸人さんを呼んだショー、それを3ヶ月やりました。
35 years ago, I entered Yoshimoto Kogyo. I graduated from school and entered the company. And one of the big things that I remember during my career is that we have a main theater in Osaka. It is called the Osaka Namba Grand Kagetsu Theater. It was renewed and we rebuilt it. And at that time, there was a project to do a long-running program for 3 months. There were two actual programs of that nature. One was called American Variety Van. And basically what that was we took the highlight scenes from various successful Broadway musicals and we recreated them in one big show. Another project that we had running for for 3 months was called Hakurai Yose. And this basically means that we took very interesting, entertaining skits and shows from people worldwide, entertainers worldwide, and we put them together again in a very interesting package.
それがすごく入社した頃の楽しい思い出でした。そしてそれから数年後、後にアメリカに、CAA、クリエイティブアシストエージェンシーというアメリカ最大の、多分世界最大のタレントエージェンシーがあることも知りました。
That was one of the most wonderful projects that I was involved in after I entered the company. And some years later, I learned of the existence of a very famous company. I think all of you may know this, CAA, the Creative Artists Agency, a talent management agency based in the United States, probably the largest in the United States, probably the largest in the world.
まあ、若い頃にいつかはうちの会社もアジアの CAA になるんだと思って、まあ、おぼろげながらですけれども、そういうふうにして現場のお笑いタレントのマネージメントを、まあ、サラリーマン生活をしていました。
So again, this was all happening when I was very, very young. But even then, I had great dreams. I had this kind of nebulous dream of eventually creating Yoshimoto Kogyo into the CAA, Creative Artists Agency of Asia. Even with this sort of nebulous or vague or ambitious goal in my mind, I worked very, very hard as a salaried employee of Yoshimoto Kogyo. I looked after all of the wonderful entertainers that belonged to our agency.
で、時は流れ、この度クールジャパン機構様のご協力ご援助を得て、いよいよその一歩が始まるという次第です。
And yet, after many years had passed, today I am very, very happy. The reason is that because of the very kind and magnanimous support and cooperation of the Cool Japan Fund, we are able now to take the first step into realizing this dream that I had as a young man.
で、先ほどもご紹介いただきましたように MCIP という会社を、設立しまして、横手というのが社長として就任をしました。
And so that leads me to what was mentioned earlier. We have now established, in conjunction with other companies, a new company called MCIP Holdings. And Ms. Yokote, who is sitting next to me, is the president of this new organization.
バトンタッチです。
And I would now like to turn the microphone over to Ms. Yokote.
ただいまご紹介に預かりました、MCIP ホールディングスの社長を務めさせていただいております横手でございます。よろしくお願いいたします。大崎はフライデーに出るぐらいちょっとした有名人なんですけれども残念ながら私の方は、MCIP ホールディングスの社長ということで10月30日に発表させていただくまではインターネットで検索しても名前が出てこないようなもう極めてロープロファイルな人生を送ってたんですけれども10月30日の発表を皮切りにちょっと検索すると2チャンネルに誰みたいなこととか書かれたりとか、いう感じでちょっとこんな場でお話をさせていただくような、ものではないんですが、今日のような時間を、いただきましてありがとうございます。
So I've just received this very kind introduction and I would like to introduce myself. My name is Yokote and I am the president of MCIP Holdings. As Mr. Osaki mentioned a few moments ago, he is rather a famous gentleman. He was featured on Friday, the very famous scandal-loving magazine for some time. However, I myself have lived a very low-profile life until there was this announcement made about MCIP Holdings being established on October 31st of this year. If you search for my name on the internet, you would come up with nothing. That's how little known I was. However, after October 31st and this announcement, the press releases came out. If you search for my name, the first entry that comes up is the big blog site, Channel 2, which is rather a mean site where people basically criticize each other. And when my name comes up, people are asking, who is this person? So I would like to, again, introduce myself by saying that I'm really not someone who really has the, really deserves to be sitting in front of you speaking today, but I am very, very glad for this opportunity. And my age has also become public knowledge.
はい、それでは10月30日に発表させていただきました、MCIP ホールディングスなんですけれどもについて、ご説明を簡単にさせていただきたいと思います。電通、ドワンゴ、ソニーミュージックエンターテインメント、慈恵学園グループ、そしてイオンモール、吉本興業の民間の6社が、出資をいたしまして、さらにそこに、クールジャパン機構のご支援をいただいて、合弁会社 MCIP ホールディングスという会社を、今年11月に、設立いたしました。記者発表の時にはちょっとご説明できなかった、この会社の事業理念と、あとこれから、近日始動できると思う、プロジェクト具体的なプロジェクトについて、簡単にご紹介させていただければと思います。
So again, I'd like to take this opportunity to tell you a little bit about this new organization of which I serve as the head. At the end of October, it was announced that six private companies, Dentsu Incorporated, Duango Company Limited, Sony Music Entertainment Incorporated, the GK Group of Colleges, Aeon Mall Company Limited, and Yoshimoto Kogyo. These six companies, with the cooperation and support of Cool Japan Fund, was able to establish a joint venture, a joint company called MCIP Holdings. We did have a press conference to announce the formation of this new organization. At that time, I could not go into much detail, but today I would like to take this opportunity to tell you a little bit about the concept or thinking behind this organization and two specific initiatives that we will be starting shortly.
はい、記者会見の時にも発表させていただいたんですけれども、MCIP の事業内容について、このように述べたんですが、アジア各国で日本のコンテンツを創造発信し、日本のファンを増やし、さらには日本産業への需要拡大を目指す。というふうに述べました。これ、聞いてみるとほとんどのクールジャパン戦略を掲げている会社が同じような戦略でだと思うんですけれども、これクールジャパン機構が、支援を、している案件以外でもクールジャパン戦略を掲げている会社はこのような、事業内容ということを皆さんおっしゃってるんじゃないかなと思います。そんな中で MCIP が、どのように独自性を持っているのか、なぜ、我々なりにそれが実現できるかについて簡単に説明させていただければと思います。
So at the press conference, we announced that what MCIJP was going to be doing was basically to follow the Cool Japan strategy, and that is basically to create more interesting Japanese contents and to promote these new contents throughout Asia in order to be able to create more fans of Japan throughout the world and eventually to help create more demand for Japanese industries. Certainly, this is an admirable goal, and I think all of the companies that are involved in MCIP are very much holding fast to this idea. However, there are many other companies in Japan that are also emphasizing similar goals. So what I would like to talk to you about, what I would like to talk about today to you is how MCIP is different. What is our, what is unique about us? What separates us from other companies in Japan?
まず MCIP、MCIP のクールジャパンの中心にあるのが人であるということが大きいかと思います。クールジャパンは成長戦略とか海外需要開拓である前に人々を魅了するコンテンツがなければできないものだと思っております。一つ、そしてその一つ一つのコンテンツの中にそれを作り出す人、クリエイターだったりとかパフォーマーというのが存在するというふうに思ってます。クールジャパン戦略っていうのが語られるとき、仕組みだったり手法だったり座組だったりといった方法論が語られがちですが、MCIP のクールジャパンというのはまず人があるというふうに思っております。
So if I can summarize the difference between our approach and everyone else's approach, it is that MCIP feels very, very strongly that in order to make the Cool Japan strategy successful, you have to focus on people. Everything has to be centered around people. Certainly, people talk about the Cool Japan strategy. They talk about trying to create attractive contents. But much of the conversation tends to go around methodology. In other words, what kind of mechanism or scheme should we put in place? What kind of measures, methods should we take? What kind of performance should we put into different contents, etc. But what tends to be forgotten is that fundamentally, if you want to create attractive, appealing contents, you have to find the right people. You have to find the right creators, the right performers. And it is only in that way that you're able to create truly attractive contents. And that is where our strength, MCIP's strength, lies.
MCIP の、アライアンス企業の一つである吉本興業は、マネジメントを生業とする会社です。その創業の当時から人のお世話をすることに始まり、102年間にわたってそののれんを守って信頼とブランドを、構築してきた会社です。この、吉本興業が、イーダーシッペとなってこの MCIP という会社を、立ち上げてきたわけですけれども、まずこの会社が手掛けていくクールジャパン展開の、は当然のことながら、人が真ん中にいるというふうに、考えていただいていいかと思います。
The reason I focus on this idea of people being at the center of all of our activities is that the heart of MCIP, the alliance of companies that join MCIP, is Yoshimoto Kogyo. And Yoshimoto Kogyo, as has been explained earlier, basically has this 100-year history of managing entertainers from the very first days of its establishment. It has taken care of looking after different entertainers. It has a 102-year history of looking after people. And it is as a result of its efforts that it has built this tremendous brand.And great trust within different industries. Therefore, with Yoshimoto Kogyo taking the leadership, we know that MCIP will be a company that will focus on people as it pushes forward with the Cool Japan strategy.
人と人が集まる場を作って、そこにコンテンツが生まれ、そこからコンテンツが広がっていく、そうしたコンテンツを、得意分野が異なるこの民間6社が、知恵を集めてアジアで愛されるよう支持されるように展開していくこと、そのような展開が図れることが MCIP の強みだというふうに考えております。
In other words, we fundamentally believe Yoshimoto Kogyo's ideas, which is that what is important is to bring people together, provide a venue for people to come together, because that is the only way that true interesting contents will become born. And once you have these interesting contents that are created, you can now work to spread or promote these contents throughout the world. And in the terms of promoting the contents, we have these six different companies that are very, very successful and have diverse areas of expertise. We know that with their strength helping Yoshimoto Kogyo's fundamental ideas, we will be able to create a place in Asia where Japanese contents will be loved and supported.
ここから、MCIP がこれから、進めていく具体的なプロジェクトについてご説明させていただきたいと思います。まず、アジア版住みますプロジェクトを、来年早々に始めさせていただきたいと思っております。
So now, I've been talking in broad terms, and now I'd like to talk a little bit about specific projects that we are embarking upon. The first one is called the Asia version of the Sumimasu, or We Will Live There project. We're going to begin this early next year.
2015年初旬から、インドネシア、タイ、台湾を皮切りに、アジア各国の地、各国地域に吉本のタレントを移住させます。同時に各国のタレントや、歌手、ダンサーなど日本に住みたいと希望する人たちを吉本が受け入れて日本での活動やレッスンや、そういったお手伝いをしていきます、いわゆる、才能の、相互交流みたいなことを、始めていきたいと思っています。
This is a very, very interesting project、that we have already been doing in Japan. In other words, we take、very interesting entertainers, comedians、and、let them live in different prefectures in Japan. Now we're expanding this idea and taking interesting comedians and entertainers from Yoshimoto Kogyo in Japan and making them live in different countries throughout Asia. We're going to start at the beginning of next year by having people live in Indonesia, also Thailand, and also Taiwan. And it's not going to be a unilateral or one-way process. At the same time, we're going to be searching for and finding interesting entertainers to come to Japan. They may want to live here, and we will help them. Yoshimoto Kogyo will take care of them, look after them, help them with lessons, help them build careers in Japan. In other words, it is a mutual cultural talent exchange between countries here.
そのために MCIP では各国の、マネジメント会社等と提携を進めてまいります、海外のマネジメント会社が抱えるタレントの日本での活動を吉本ないしは MCIP がサポートする一方で現地に移り住んだ吉本のタレントの現地での活動をサポートしてもらうという形を取っていきたいと思っております。
In order to realize this, MCIP is actively developing partnerships and relationships with different talent or entertainment management companies in various parts of Asia. In other words, the different entertainers that are managed by companies in different Asian countries, they can come to Japan. Yoshimoto Kogyo will look after them and offer them support. At the same time, Yoshimoto Kogyo will send its own celebrities to these different countries, and the local management agencies will look after them as well.
ちょっとそのまま日本のコンテンツを輸出する方が早いんじゃないかとか、なんでそのような回りくどい方法なのかというご意見もあるかもしれません。ただ我々が考えるのは、一方的な文化輸出ということは場合によっては拒絶的な反応や摩擦を生んでしまうこともあるし、例えばそれが一時的な利益を生んだとしても、コンテンツ単位のトライアンドエラーみたいなことの繰り返しになってしまうということが、今までの経験でも何度もありました。我々としては、たとえ時間がかかったとしてもアジアの国をそれぞれ理解して、受け入れられるコンテンツはどんなものなのかなのかという勘どころをつかんでいくというようなことをやっていきたいと思っています。そういった勘どころを見極めたところで相互理解に基づいた文化の発信を行いたいというふうに考えております。
Some people may say that this is a very convoluted or complex way of doing things. Wouldn't it simply be easier to just export Japanese contents as it is to different countries. This kind of cultural export seems like a much easier idea. Certainly that is one way to approach this issue. However, depending on the situation, that kind of unilateral simply pushing out Japanese culture might actually inspire resentful feelings in different countries. It might lead to frictions, tensions, and even if you're able to make some kind of profits on a temporary basis, we don't think over the long term it's a successful way to proceed. In other words, you try different contents, you export it, it's a trial and error process, but the trial and error process simply keeps repeating itself endlessly. We don't think that's the way to go. We believe that even if it takes a longer time, it takes more effort, what is important is for us to be able to study and understand the characteristics of each different local market, to be able to therefore create contents that are truly appealing to the people who live in these countries. And once we understand what is truly appealing to these countries, then we will be able to create create interesting content that will be well accepted and loved, hopefully, by people in different nations. That, we think, is the true way to promote a culture.
もう一つはマネジメントを中心とした事業展開の考え方にマネタイズの観点からも有望だと言えるかなと思っている点があります。例えばタイのテレビ番組の制作費というのは日本のテレビ番組の制作費に比べると、10分の1程度の、なんですけれども、そのこと自体が、日本のコンテンツをそのまま輸出していくっていうことに、とてもペイしないというような結果が、出たりしておりますが、一方で、タイの超有名なタレントが CM 契約で数千万の年間、契約を結んでいるというようなマーケットもあったりして、そういうふうに考えると、人を育てていくと、現地で育てていくということが、遠回りに見えても、結果的には事業として、有効になっていくのではないかなというふうにも考えております。
Also, we believe that this kind of management process, business management business model is very effective from a business point of view. What I mean by this is that if you look at a country such as Thailand, it is often said that TV production costs are 1/10 of the costs of what it costs to produce a program in Japan. Therefore, if you just simply export a program to Thailand from Japan, then it doesn't pay. In other words, there aren't enough profits. However, on the other hand, Thailand is an interesting country. If you have a very, very popular celebrityThat celebrity can command a huge amount of money to appear on television commercials, tens of millions of yen, similar to what a Japanese celebrity might ask for. In other words, we believe that over the long term, it is important and effective from a business point of view to take the time and effort to nurture stars in particular countries and make sure that they have great success.
現在海外に移住したいという芸人を募っておりまして、すでに100名近い芸人が自ら手を挙げてくれています。海外で人気者になりたいという意思を持った、好奇心の高い若手芸人たちが、たくさん立候補してくれています。その中から第1弾、タイ、インドネシア等に行ってもらう芸人を、早々に決定して、また皆さんにご紹介できればと思っております。
At present, we are asking young entertainers in Japan, comedians in Japan, who might want to go to Indonesia and live for a time. Already we have over 100 volunteers. In other words, they are these young comedians who have this ambition to try to become successful in other nations and also who are full of curiosity. We are screening them now, and in a very short while, we will be able to announce the people that we have selected that we will be sending to live in Indonesia.
もう一つ、住みますプロジェクトに加えて、指導しているプロジェクトがあります。もう一つは今年の秋、アジアアニソンオーディションというプロジェクトをスタートさせました。これもアジアにおける人の発掘の一つとして今後展開していく予定です。アジアのアニソンスターを発掘すべく、アジア全域を対象にオーディションを開催し、12月初旬にシンガポールで開催されたアニメフェスティバルアジアアファというイベントの中で、同じくアファでニコニコ国会議を展開していたドワンゴさんと連携してオーディションの最終審査を行いました。シンガポール出身と中国の出身のシンガーが最終で選出されています。ソニーミュージック、今後ソニーミュージックエンターテインメントさんともご一緒し、国内でデビューを図り、さらにアジアでこのシンガーたちを、日本のアニソンを背負って活躍できるスターに成長させていきたいと思っています。
So the Sumimasu or living in your community project is going to be very, very successful, we believe. We also have another initiative, and this has to do with singing. This fall, we started a new project called the Asia Anime Song Auditions Project. We believe this is a new way to discover interesting talent in Asia. We had auditions for this audition project throughout Asia, and in December of this year, we had the finals. In other words, in Singapore, we had the Anime Festival Asia, AFA, big event, and we had the final auditions, the final judging there. The Anime Festival Asia, AFA, was also broadcast by one of our partners, Duango, on something called their Japan Internet Culture Festival channel. So we cooperated with them and eventually had the final audition selection process, and singers from Singapore and China were selected. Now we're using one of our other partners, Sony Music Entertainment, and now we're going to be helping launch the careers of these winners, not only in Japan, but throughout Asia as well. And when they are promoted throughout Asia, they will be promoted as singers of Japanese anime songs.
今後このように各国で人の発掘、そして人気者の育成をしていくことを基軸としながら、MCIP はこうした人を基盤にしたさまざまなコンテンツを各国で開発していきます。イベント、テレビ、デジタルなどのツールを使った発信を行うことによって、各地でのエンターテインメントの基盤を構築していきます。
So in the future, we will continue work with all of our partners. MCIP will work very hard to discover interesting new entertainers, talented new celebrities. We will help them to grow. We will give them lessons and guidance. And eventually, again, focused on people as the basis of our activities, we will use events, we will use television, we will use digital technology to ensure that entertainment becomes very popular throughout this region.
お話に出てきたドワンゴさんや、ソニーミュージックエンターテインメントさんに比べて加えて、今後、アライアンスの一社である電通さんにスポンサーセールスやビジネスパッケージ の戦略を作っていただく等 のご尽力を図っていただいたりとか、またソニー時計さんにはスクール のノウハウや、カリキュラムの提供などを行っていっていただいたりとか、またイオンモールさんに関しましては、イオンモールさんは、出資ではなく場の提供ということで、アジア各国で のイオンモールさんの場を、日本のコンテンツに触れる機会となるような、場として提供いただくということで、この MCIP の事業に貢献いただくというふうに考えております。
So again, I've explained a little bit about how Yoshimoto Kogyo is going to be working with its alliance partners, such as Duango and Sony Music Entertainment. In addition, we have, again, very, very strong partners. We have Dentsu Incorporated. We are working with them now to create strategies to be able to secure sponsors for many of these future events, also to create an overall business package that we will be able to develop throughout this region. Also, we do have one of our partners, the GK School of Colleges. They have great expertise in being able to train and guide younger persons, and also how to form classes and lessons. We want to be able to use their strengths. Also, our other partner, Aeon Mall, they are not making a capital investment in MCIP, but rather they are producing venues, places in different areas of Asia where people will be able to actually see and feel and touch and experience Japanese culture. So they're going to be providing us with venues. So these are the great partners that we have at MCIP.
はい、MCIP の事業説明は以上になります。ありがとうございました。
Thank you for your kind attention.
Okay, and before we go to questions, I forgot to say, if you have your cell phones, if you could just turn them on to like manner mode, and then into the introductions. Takamatsu-san's name, it just slipped my mind. I just sort of went blank. So introduce Takamatsu, our interpreter, who's, I think, been with us for years and years now. So anyway, before we, I guess, go to questions from the working press, I just had a couple questions, I guess a couple for Mr. Osaki and then a couple for Ms. Yokote. I guess one is, I mean, Yoshimoto Kogyo, I mean, from what I understand, their main business or their largest business is the management of talent. And I was just wondering, I mean, what kind of revenue model is that? How does that sort of, I know the company is no longer listed, but I'm just sort of curious because I think people, they know that you do all these things and they're probably wondering how the company gains its revenues.
はい、私の方から先に大崎社長そして横手社長に質問させていただければと思うのでございます。吉本興業、という会社でございますが、主なビジネスはそのタレントのマネジメントだというふうに、理解しております。多くの人たちも同じような理解を持っていると思うのでございます。今は非常上という形になっているのでございますが、もし、差し障りがなければ、どういう収益、モデルビジネスモデルというのを持っていらっしゃるんでしょうか。つまりその収入源というのはどういうふうに内訳はどのような感じになっているのでございますでしょうか。
はい、
なんか表情に乏しいうちの横手さんよりも玉子さんの方がハートフルに語っていただいたので本当にありがとうございます。悪気があるわけじゃなく、将来そういういい子なんですけれども、すいません。いわゆる放送局さん、東京のキー局さん、関西の準キー局様、あと全国のいろんな放送局様からタレントが出演をしてそのギャランティーをいただいたり、ユニット番組のテレビの番組を制作したりという収入と、大阪のなんばグランド花月、東京のルミネ座吉本を中心に全国にいくつかある劇場からの入場料収入と、あとは代理店さんからいただくタレントのコマーシャル出演料等との収入と、全国にいろんなイベントをしている収入と、あとはCD、DVD、タレントお笑いタレントたちの DVD ですね、テレビの番組の DVD で若干 その配信からの収入が主な収入です。
So yes, we work very closely with broadcasters throughout Japan. We work with the main broadcasting companies, key stations in Tokyo, also the ones in Kansai, and actually throughout the nation. Some of them are very large stations, some of them are smaller broadcasters, but we work with all of them. And our revenue is broken down in this way. First of all, many of our celebrities or entertainers appear in many of the programs on all of these broadcasters, and we receive their salaries and receive, of course, a part of that salary. We also produce some programs for these stations as well. Also, as was mentioned earlier, we do have many theaters that we run in Japan. The biggest one, of course, is the Grand Kagetsu Theater in Namba, but we also have many in Tokyo as well, and so we have a great deal of revenue from ticket sales. Also, many of our celebrities are fortunate enough to be able to appear in different commercials. As a result, we're able to derive income from their guarantees for the sponsorship monies as well. Also, we run many, many different kinds of events throughout the nation, and again, we receive some income from that. We also have CDs and DVDs that are produced by some of our comedians, some television programs that are changed into DVDs or CDs. And also, we received a slight amount of income from some digital transmission of these kinds of entertainment programs.
And I know that the renewed international push is partly because of the, I guess, the Japanese domestic market in terms of the demographics, I guess the shrinking and aging population. I was just wondering, I mean, how is that affecting your business? I mean, is it actually impacting it in a negative way, or is it just, or is things just sort of flat as the population slowly declines and now you're trying to look for sort of overseas markets?
で結構ビジネス的な質問になってしまうのでございますが、今その、海外に目を向け始めているということなんでございますが、その理由について伺いたいと思います。日本 その人口構成、今後 その人口動態を考えますと、これはやはりその、御社 そのビジネスモデルに、悪影響を与えているんでしょうか。悪影響を与えているほどでもなく、ただ、ビジネスもなかなか成長しないというようなことなんでしょうか。つまりその人口 その動きというのがその海外に行くその大きな動機づけになっているんでしょうか。
はい、もともと、アジアの CAA になるんだって小さな胸をに誓ったことがありまして、そういう意味では二十数年前からアジアに行きたいなと思ってました。でそれは 毎日がこう別に遊んでるわけじゃないんですけれども、学園祭のような仕事をしてて、毎日楽しいなと思いながらこう35年間仕事をしてきたもんですから、いろんな国の人たちと楽しいねって言っていろんなイベントをしたり、タレントのマネジメントというか育成をしたり、そういうことを、こんなに楽しいならいろんな国の人たちともっとやりたいなっていうのがもともとのその素朴なというか動機なもんですから、そういう意味ではこの25年30年その流れの中で来たということです。もちろん日本の国がこう少子高齢化に向けてこうシュリンクしてきて、マーケットを新しいマーケットを開拓しなきゃいけない、作らなきゃいけないということも外部環境的にはありますけれども、まあそんなことよりも元々のその楽しさを共有するということをもっと楽しく激しくやりたいというのが元々の動機です。あまり答えにはなってないかもしれません。
I don't know if this will be an adequate enough answer to your question, but as I mentioned earlier, over 20 years ago, I did develop this dream in my little heart of eventually becoming the CAA, Creative Artists Agency of Asia. And that is something that I promised to myself that I would achieve someday. Having said this, however, our business is one in which we find ourselves enjoying life every single day. It's not that we're just playing or goofing off, but our work is such that it is almost like being in part of a college sort of drama or comedy skit production almost on a daily basis, or a college festival on a daily basis. And so work has been a great deal of fun. It's been wonderful to be able to help new talented people develop their skills and become even more successful. It's also given us opportunities to be able to work with people from other nations as well. Our fundamental idea, as was explained by Ms. Yokote, is that we like to center around people. We like to share enjoyment with people. We like to help people grow. And so, again, this idea that I had for 25, 30 years of wanting to eventually expand into Asia and make more friends, be able to work with other management agencies, help other talented people grow, is something that I've always had. Certainly what you have pointed out, the fact that the Japanese market is shrinking, that because of the graying society with fewer children, we do have this need probably to develop overseas markets. That is one factor. These outside factors, we're not immune to them, but that has not been the fundamental or main reason for our wanting to go abroad now.
And then I just had one question for Ms. Yokote. I guess looking at one of the first projects with the, I guess, the celebrities living overseas, it seems like the countries, I mean, those are very, I guess, countries that are fairly close to Japan. Was there any discussion about maybe sending people to Korea or China, which I think would be really interesting because of the, I think, the closer sort of cultural and historical ties between those two countries and Japan?
I'm sorry, so those countries are actually closer culturally to Japan?
Japan and China.
すみません、最初、横田様にその質問なんでございます。最初にその住みますプロジェクトを推進することにあたりまして、インドネシア、台湾、などを選んでらっしゃるんでございますが、非常にまあ文化的にも近い、逆ですよね、あんまり文化的に近くないような国をお選びになっているという印象をちょっと受けるんでございます。最初に住みますプロジェクトでございましたら、もっとそのまあ歴史的につながりが深いような、例えばあるいは地理的に近い韓国とか、まあ、中国とか、そういうような国を考えなかった理由はあるんでしょうか。 なぜこのこういうようなタイとかインドネシアなどの国を最初に選びましたんでしょうか。
中国、韓国にも行く可能性は、十分にあります。一番最初に、芸人から行きたいところを募ったりとか、まあ、そういう流れの中で、インドネシア、タイっていうのを最初にするということと、あともう一つは受け入れの体制とか、まあ、そういった部分も含めて早い段階で行って、第一弾で行けるのがタイとインドネシアということで、今後韓国だったりとか中国だったりとかも可能性は十分にあると思います。
Oh, yes, there is a great possibility that eventually our celebrities will be going to live in China and South Korea and other nations which have perhaps more closer historical cultural connections with Japan. The reason that these other countries were chosen first is that, first of all, when we asked for volunteers and asked these entertainers where they might want to go, the countries such as Indonesia, Thailand came up first, and so that's part of the reason. And the other reason is that we already had some connections with local people, organizations there, and it would be easier to work out a relationship for these countries first. That's why they were chosen.
Okay. Anyway, I'd like to go to questions from the working press. First, just if you could state your affiliation and keep it to one question. No, go ahead.
Mr. Ozaki, I'm from Iris Media for the Middle East. Entertainment industries everywhere in the world is a growth sector. Your idea looks very different from the traditional concept. Dubai invests a lot in this sector, who bring an important contribution to the economy of this emirate. Can you clarify the goal you want to reach by your project? And is it allowed to get foreign investment in this project? Thank you.
はい、アイリスメディア、中東のメディアでございます。その世界を見ましても、やっぱりそのエンターテインメント分野というのは成長分野だというふうに言われているわけでございます。しかしながら今のその話を聞いておりますと、今までのそのエンターテインメントの会社のその戦略とちょっと違うことを提案しているような感じがいたしますので、非常に興味深くお話を聞いておりました。まあ、例えばその UAE あるいはドバイなどもこういうようなその事業に投資したいという人たち会社などもたくさんあるわけでございますが、まあ質問2つあるんでございますが、最終的に何を達成したい、最終的な究極な目標というのは何でございますでしょうか。そして外国のその投資などもその受け入れるそのご準備はあるんでございますでしょうか。お気持ちはあるんでございますでしょうか。
For Mr. Osaki. ご質問ありがとうございます。最終的なというか、まあ、夢といいますか、望むところはそれぞれの国がそれぞれの文化をもっと確立して、激しく世界中でその文化が交流すること、交換されることみたいなことが夢に描いているようなイメージです。もちろんそういう意味ではいろんな国のいろんな企業、いろんな団体の方にいろんな形でご参加いただくっていうのは望むところですし、ぜひそうありたいと思ってます。
So when your question as to our fundamental goal or ultimate goal, it's a rather difficult question to answer, but I can say that my dream is to be able to ensure that each nation is able to develop its own unique culture, and that once its own unique culture has been established and the contents have been created, that these contents can go out into the world and almost even do battle with each other, in other words, compete with each other. And I think that will create for a much more lively world. So in that sense, this is a global effort. So in that sense, we do welcome the participation and support of companies and other organizations from all over.
Okay. Oh, go ahead.
I'm from Singapore Press Holdings. I have two questions, and one is for Mr. Osaki, and another one is for Ms. Yokote. So glad that you have a women CEO here. And I'd like to know that, is Osaki, are you a Abenomics supporter, since Mr. Abe is now very support that having more and more women CEOs? And for Yokote-san, I'd like to ask you about, since I know that Japan is very good, like in my when the time I was a student in 1980s, I already watched Yamaguchi Momoe's TV series. But for so many years, that Japanese dramas and everything, they cannot compete for these few years. I mean, these 10 years, they cannot compete with Korea. What is the reasons? Thank you.
はい、2つの質問があります。1つは大崎社長、もう1つは横手社長でございます。大崎様でございますが、今回はこの MCIP ホールディングスの社長に女性を抜擢されたということは非常に私たちは歓迎しております。まあ、女性をお選びになったということでございますので、アベノミクスの、まあ、女性を輝かせるという政策の支援者だと解釈してよろしいんでしょうか。で、2つ目の質問は横手様にでございますが、私も80年代日本に、で勉強しておりましたときに、学生だったときに素晴らしいドラマがたくさん日本で作られていたわけでございます。私も山口百恵さんのテレビシリーズの大ファンだったんですが、この、まあ、十数年、日本のドラマというのは世界の市場では負けているのではないかと思います。まあ、特に韓国ドラマなどに負けていると思いますが、その理由は何だと思われますでしょうか。
はい、ご質問ありがとうございます。横手さんを社長にというのは、近い将来こういう今日のような機会が与えていただけるんじゃないかなということもございまして、いわゆる私のようなこうおっさんでこうがさつな大阪弁の親父じゃなくって、いかに吉本の社員らしくない人をということで、女性で声が小さくて英語がしゃべれるという基準で、基準です。で、もちろん安倍首相のそういうご発言もありましたが、それ以前から私は女性を崇拝もしておりますし、愛してもおりますので、ということです。なんでしょう、今日だからということもないんですし、ちょっと発言がずれるんですけれども、いわゆるその安倍首相の右傾化みたいなことをいろいろな、それこそ韓国、中国のメディアも含めて、いろいろこう、今、選挙が終わって書かれておるんですけれども、そもそもその保守、日本でいう保守っていうのはどうなのかとか、共産主義っていうのはどうなのかっていうのも、すごく、僕たちお笑いとは全く政治とは関係ないとはいうものの、いろんな各国の方々と文化の交流をする際に考えたり議論しなきゃいけないことだと思います。東京での共産党というのと、今沖縄での知事選が終わった後の沖縄での共産党、沖縄県民の共産党というのもすごくニュアンスというかイメージが理解が近かったりもしますし、まあ、そういう意味では日本国内でもいろんなこう思想考え分析があると思いますし、そういうのがちょうどもう一度見直す機会でもあると思いますので、まあ、そういうことも含めて文化の交流とそういうことを、敬愛する女性と一緒に考えたいということです。
Thank you very much for your question. Part of the reason that we chose, or I had Ms. Yokota become president of this new company, is that I knew that we would be able to have a press conference like this in the near future. And at that time, when we have these kinds of events, I wanted to make sure that the head of the new company was not someone like myself. In other words, a middle-aged, roughshod kind of Osaka dialect, a man who might not give a very, very positive impression to many, many people. In other words, I wanted to bring someone who had grace and elegance and was not your typical Yoshimoto Kogyo employee. I wanted someone who was a lady who would speak in a small voice and who could also speak English. So these are the main prerequisites for me choosing Ms. Yokote. Of course, Mr. Abe has talked about women shining and all of these policies to promote women. But even before he's made these statements, I have for many, many years loved, respected, adored women. And that has never changed. And since we're on the topic of Mr. Abe, I know this did not come up as a question, but this is an opportune time, so I would like to make one other comment, which is that because of the election results the other day, there are many, many articles in the media, especially Chinese and Korean media, about the growing leaning toward the right in Japanese politics in Japan. In other words, when we talk about conservatism in Japan, we talk about even communism in Japan. Of course, these are topics that have nothing to do directly with the world of comedy in which we conduct our business. Having said this, however, as we do expand to other nations, as we do develop more relationships with people from other nations, these kinds of topics will come up. These are things that we must think about. And I would just like to say that the election results have given us great food for thought. One is that when we talk about concepts such as communism, the communism image that people in Tokyo have and the communism image that people in Okinawa have, especially after the gubernatorial elections that were just simply held, that were held recently there, they're very, very different. So even within the country, I think this is a very good opportunity for people throughout the nation to start a discussion about what these concepts about conservatism, communism, just in general politics are all about. I think this is going to be a very important foundation for us as we move forward to establishing closer cultural ties and cultural exchange with other nations. Excuse me, there was another question for Ms. Yokote. Sorry. Sure.
ご質問ありがとうございます。韓国の、クールコリアとの、違いだと思うんですけれども、まず一つ、は、もともと韓国、まあ、私の、分かる範囲ではまずそもそも韓国自体が小さなマーケットだったということで、まあ、中国だったりとか海外の市場を意識したコンテンツを作っていくという戦略を持っていたということが一つ大きくあるかなと思います。加えてクールコリア戦略という、まあ、国を挙げて の文化の輸出ということを大胆に、やられたということで、まあ、それが本当に、まあ、成功を収めているということだと思います。確かにインドネシアだったりタイだったり、各国のアジアの人たちとエンターテインメントの話をするとやっぱり韓流ブームというのはどこの国でもあって、それは本当に素晴らしい、成功ではないかなと思います。ただ、まあ、今後その、我々がやろうとする、クールジャパン戦略は、まあ、単純に日本の、コンテンツをそのままということではなく、先ほども申し上げた通り、地元の、地域の人たちの目線に合ったコンテンツを作っていくという、まあ、ローカライズしていくということをやっていくということになるので、ちょっとその、差別化しつつ、コリア韓流ブームに、勝てるようなエンターテインメント展開が、やれていけたらなというふうに思っております。
Thank you very much for your question. And certainly when we talk about South Korean entertainment, we think of the cool Korea strategy. And I guess basically what you're asking is the difference between our strategy and the cool Korea strategy. And first of all, I'd like to point out that to the best of my knowledge, the South Korea approach was very, very different from its very, very beginnings. The reason being that the South Korean market is much smaller than the Japanese market. So from the very beginning, Korea had to look outside to overseas markets. As it developed its entertainment industry. And as a result, it had the full backing of the government. And as you can see, it has been a tremendous success. Even as we talk with our counterparts and our partners in Indonesia, Thailand, we all talk about this South Korea success story in the entertainment world. We call this the Kanryu or Korean flow or Korean wave boom in Japan. It has many, many fans in Japan, but it has many, many fans in other Asian countries as well. However, as I mentioned earlier, our approach, the Cool Japan approach, is very different from the Cool Korea approach, primarily because we don't want to develop contents and export it unilaterally abroad. But rather, as I explained in some detail earlier, what we are trying to do is work very closely with our local counterparts to try to better understand the characteristics and the desires and the needs of local populations. In other words, to be on the same eye level, literally, as the people in these nations. In other words, to local contents. And I think that will be how we will be able to distinguish the Cool Japan products from the Cool Korea products. And through this, we hope to eventually be able to supersede the Cool Korea entertainment in the business. Thank you.
Okay, Savindri.
Takuchi from Interpress Service. I'm kind of interested in the exchange of comedians between Japan and Asia, and I know Cool Japan is to promote Japanese culture in Asia, but with comedians, Asian comedians coming to Japan, I'd like to ask Mr. Ozaki, what can Japan learn from Asia?
はい、インタープレス、の各種と申します。特にその芸人、コメディアン、の交流というお話について非常に興味を、持っているわけでございます。まあ、クールジャパン戦略というのは基本的にはその文化交流ということだと思うんでございますが、特にその海外から芸人を日本にまあ招待して、まあ、住ませるということでございますが、何を期待してらっしゃるんでしょうか。どういうようなことを日本側がそういうような外国の、そのコメディアンとかから学べると思いますのでしょうか。
はい、ご質問ありがとうございます。日本の、僕たちの若いタレントたちがアジア、ASEAN の各国に住んだり、逆にそういうコメディアンの人たちや歌手の人たちを日本に迎えるという、まあ、基本的にその一方通行じゃない、お迎えできるから訪ねていった時もまた仲良くなれるということで、一方通行じゃないようにしようというのが、まあ、シンプルな基本的な考えだと思います。そしてやっぱり共に生活をするようなことで、お互いの考え、個人の考えや、それぞれの国の事情みたいなことも理解し合って、それはすごく時間がかかると思いますが、共に暮らすということ、共に仕事をするということでしかできないような気がしますので、まあ、そういう意味でアジアの人たちも日本に迎えてということをやらなければ成立しないと思います。前段で横手さんがアニメソングの女性たちのオーディションをやったって、まあ、もちろん1位2位の女性は日本で華々しくデビューするように頃から、1年かけていろいろやるんですけれども、そこで落っこちた12、3名の女の子たちもいてまして、まあ、僕たちはその落っこちた女性の子を、まあ、親御さんの了解を得ながら、まあ、全員の子とこう契約をしてですね、その子たちの子と一緒にこうマネジメントをできたらなと思ってますし、まあ、そういう意味では割と吉本ってこう私を筆頭にこう落ちこぼれがどう生きていくかみたいな会社ですので、ちょうどいいんじゃないかなと思ってます。
Thank you very much for your question. I think this idea of bringing young, talented entertainers from other countries and having them live in Japan and sending our young, talented entertainers and having them live in these different countries, this is our fundamental approach. It's a fundamental way of thinking. We don't want to do anything unilaterally. It can't be just one-way exchange. It has to be two-way exchange. And that's the basis of our approach. It's a very, very simple idea, but we think that unless you live together and work together, you cannot really understand each other on an individual basis. You cannot understand the social situation in each country. You can't understand the traditions, way of thinking. This is a very time-consuming process, but I believe that this is the only way that we can truly learn from each other. And what we can learn, I don't know yet, but we believe that we truly can learn from each other. As Ms. Yokota said a few moments ago, we did have this very, very big festival, big audition competition, the anime song auditions. And the first prize winner and the second prize winner is China and Singapore. These winners are now we're going to spend a year training them, guiding them, so that they will be able to make very, very splashy debuts in Japan. However, there are girls that did not make first place and second place. There are 12 or 13 young ladies that did not win. However, we would like to be able to get permission from their families and also their management agencies, and we would also like to be able to contract with them and look after them as entertainers. Because after all, at Yoshimoto Kogyo, we have this fundamental idea that it's the people who are not the most successful, the people who aren't the best and the brightest, including myself, that can eventually be nurtured to become wonderful people. And so therefore, I think that the idea of taking the non-winners under our wing is very much in line with our corporate philosophy.
先ほど横手さんがまあ、それもそれで正しいことなんですけれども、韓国のドラマにも勝てるようにしなければいけませんという意見を言ったんですけど、もちろん資本主義の世界なので数字で勝たなければいけないというのは 大前提としてあるかもしれませんが、やっぱり、その手前でシェアするというかシェアリングするということが基本だと思ってます。まずそれをやらないと日本の国の外には出ていけないと思いますので、もちろん継続的に10年20年とプロジェクトは進めていくつもりですが、そういう意味では収益を上げらないと続けることはできない。でもキーワードは勝ち負けではなくて、分かち合うといいますかシェアリングだということだと思います。もちろんちょっと矛盾してるなんか言葉面のことというかではありますけれども、そういうことだと思います。
And I would just like to also add one comment. Ms. Yokota said a few moments ago that eventually we would like to be able to produce Japanese dramas, Japanese entertainment that will be able to supersede or win over the very, very successful South Korean dramas that we're seeing now all over the world. And what she is saying is absolutely correct. She is after the president of this organization, and that is something that we have to try to achieve. And after all, we do live in a market capitalist society, so numbers, figures are the most important thing in the in the end. Having said all of this, however, I think there's another very key concept that I've been trying to emphasize throughout our press conference today, which is that, yes, we want to succeed, and yes, we want to be successful, but we also want to share. Because without this fundamental concept of sharing, I don't think Japan will be successful as it tries to expand abroad. Yes, we're going to be involved in this kind of project over the next 10 years, over the next 20 years, and yes, we do have to produce the figures and results, and we have to achieve success financially as well. But at the same time, it's not the key word is not simply win or lose, but also understanding and sharing. These are the key concepts that we hold very dear to our hearts. I know that some of what I'm saying sounds as though they're self-contradictory. However, these concepts are very important to us.
すみません。それは例えば先ほど数週間ほど前にシンガポールであったアファーのところで、いろんな各国の女の子たちがオーディションに参加をしてくれました。で、1位の子っていうのはソニーミュージックからデビューができて、ソニーグループのアニメの主題歌を歌えるということです。で、MCIP としてはあるいは吉本としては、その1位2位にならなかった12、3名の女の子をどうマネジメントしていくかというところです。でところが吉本にそういうアニメの制作をしている番組はありません。そういうお金もありません。でもその子たちを例えばネットで紹介をして彼女たちの歌を作ってください、彼女たちの歌のプロモーションビデオをアニメで作ってくださいみたいなことを呼びかけると、それは日本国中あるいはアジアのいろんな人たちからそういう楽曲の制作の提供だとか手作りのアニメの彼女たちの歌のプロモーションビデオだとか、そういうものがこう投稿される募集応募されるんじゃないかなと思ってます。そういう意味で勝ち負け、すみません、勝ち負けということよりもシェアリングというの方が、プロジェクトとしては合ってるんじゃないかな。でそれが取りも直さず日本古来のというか日本のクールジャパン、日本人の在り方じゃなかったのかなと思います。
Just as an example of what I'm saying, as was mentioned a little while ago, several weeks ago we did have this Asia Anime Film Festival, excuse me, AFA, in Singapore, and many young ladies from the region, the Asian region, came to compete, and the number one winner has now signed with Sony Music Entertainment. Her debut is assured. She's going to be part of the Sony group. She has been promised the opportunity to sing a big anime theme song produced by Sony. However, as I mentioned earlier, we at Yoshimoto Kogyo, we at MCIP are not just interested in the first place and second place winners, but also in the 12 or 13 girls who didn't win the top prizes. How are we going to manage them, however? When we get to specifics, to be quite honest, Yoshimoto Kogyo does not produce animes. We don't have a department, we don't have knowledge, we don't have the money to start producing animes. But there are other ways in which we can support these young ladies. We can introduce them via the internet, and we can call upon people and say, these are young, talented ladies, they need an opportunity, they want to sing anime songs. Would someone out there in the world of the internet like to compose a song for them? Would someone like to produce a video, an anime video for them? In other words, we believe that this is a way that we can share the potentials of these young ladies with the world and with people throughout Japan, and we believe we will get a response from people who want to compose music, perhaps, for some of these young ladies. In other words, this is a very good example of where we focused not just simply on winning and losing, but also on sharing. And this sharing idea is very, very important to us and very, very important, I think, to Cool Japan, because it represents part of Japanese society and Japanese history. This is something that has been part of the idea of communities sharing and helping each other has been part of Japanese history for centuries. So I think it's a very, very appropriate way for us to proceed.
Yokota-san, do you have anything else to add to this? Or it's okay? Okay. I guess the lady over here. Yeah. Oh, right.
Hello, I'm Nancy Snow. I'm from the United States, and I write a blog for the Huffington Post and Eurobiz. I'm doing a book on nation brand Japan. And I guess I have some concerns about this enterprise. I think it's wonderful, and it will probably be very successful. But I view culture perhaps a little differently. And the way that this is coming across is sort of the selling of culture and the packaging of people. And I believe very strongly that Japan's image and reputation in the world is enhanced more through interaction and sharing of interpersonal communication, people getting to know one another outside of perhaps anime and manga, which of course are extraordinarily popular, but they're not popular with everyone. They've already been successful for many years. My question is, how is your creative content here, which I haven't heard a whole lot about, how is it anything different or new? Or not just edgy, because there's a commodification of culture around the world, and I think a lot of people are sort of tiring of it. We want authenticity. We want to get to know each other at a very real level outside of just packaging of entertainment. Thank you.
はい、米国のスノーと申します。私はブログを、例えばハフィントンポスト、などにも書いているわけでございます。そして今までも本も出しております。日本という、国のブランドと直訳してよろしいんでしょうかという本も書いているんでございます。基本的に非常に興味深くお話を聞かせていただいたんでございますが、少し懸念している部分があるんでございます。非常に大きな試みでありまして、きっと成功するだろうというふうには思うんでございますが、しかしながら、ある意味でその文化を売るというような感じがちょっとする感じがいたします。これは御社がやっていることだけではなく、全世界において文化をパッケージする、人間をパッケージ化して、文化を売るというような、そういうの動きがあるというイメージがあります。でも日本の、先ほどもシェアリングという話もあったんでございますが、日本の、世界に置かれて持たれるイメージというのは、やはりその人間と人間の交流、インタラクションの方が重要視されているという気がするんでございます。何を申し上げたいかということでございますが、確かに今まで漫画とかアニメというのは非常に人気が出たわけでございます。しかしながら全ての人たちがそれを支持しているわけではないわけでございます。本当のその文化交流といいますのは、個人対個人、その、ものではないかと思うんでございます。確かにその、各国がこれやってその、エンターテインメントコンテンツをパッケージ化して文化として売ってみんなが楽しむ、こういう流れが今まで成功したんですけれど、みんながある意味で飽きてきた、疲れてきたというような感じも否めないかと思うんでございます。つまり文化のコモディティ化ということについて多くの人たちが疲弊して、できれば本当の姿、本当の個人と個人の、その、コネクションを欲しいというような感じがするんでございますが、そういうような中で、私の質問なんでございますが、御社がこれから考えているコンテンツ、クリエイティブなコンテンツというのは、そういうものと今までのものとどう違うんでございますでしょうか。 Was that your question? Yes. Sorry. I'm sorry, you were nodding, so I thought you understood Japanese. Sorry, I'm sorry. Difficult question.
Sono-san, ありがとうございます。なるほど。 そうですよね。
Everything you makes you say makes absolute sense.
確かにあの文化のコモディティ化ということが起こりつつあるんだと思います。で、あのそういうことをあの僕たちもあの肌で感じてまして、まず第一歩はあのいろんな国に社員や芸人の子たちを住ませてですね、いわゆるその住みますアジアプロジェクトをして現地の方と共に衣食住を共にする中で、共に新しい文化を作っていくというようなことがまずベースになければいけないんじゃないかなと思ってます。それにはあの長い時間がかかるかもしれませんが、まずそれをスタートしないといけないんじゃないかなと思ってます。あのこれは聞いた話なんですけども、 ある映画会社の方が、アジアの国に行ってその人たちにこう言われたことは、僕たちの国は戦争がずっと続いていて、今はそんなにお金もなく貧乏で、僕たちの若い人たちの文化がないんですと、僕たちは今から文化を作らなきゃいけないんです、なので、日本の人たちも一緒にここに来て僕たちの文化を作るのをお手伝いください、教えてくださいって言われたそうです。そういうことなんじゃないかなと思います。
Certainly, I understand what you're saying about the commoditization of culture. I think it's a very, very interesting term, and it's something that actually we feel with our own skin because we're exposed to it all the time. So that's part of the reason that we came up with this idea of sending people to live in different countries. And it's not just going to be the young comedians that are going to be living in these countries. We're going to be able to send our staff people there as well. And by living together, working together, eating, sharing meals together, I think this is the only way that we're going to be able to start understanding each other in any deep and meaningful way. And hopefully, this will be a very time-consuming process, but over the long term, we hope that by doing this, by gaining this kind of mutual understanding, we will together be able to create a new kind of culture. That is the foundation of everything that we're trying to do. Just as a tangential point, I recently heard someone in the film industry say that he visited an Asian country, and he was told that in our country, we've been suffering from war for years and years and years. And as a result, most of our heritage has been destroyed. We have so little money. Our young people don't really have a sense of their culture, and we need to now start rebuilding our culture. So we need the help of outside countries such as Japan. Please come help us rebuild our culture. And I think maybe that's the kind of thing that we want to respond to.
Okay. Oh, any other questions from the working press? Okay, here you go.
生島博です。フリーランスです。胡錦涛政権時代に上海行って、上海のテレビ局にプラッと寄ったんですけれども、その時に確か吉本さんのチャンネルがあって、ショッピングなどもやってらっしゃったと思うんですが、それはどうなったのか、そしてその時のレスポンス、そして今まあ反日状況は非常に強いわけですけど、その辺の状況を教えてください。
My name is Ikushima, I'm a freelancer. When Mr. Hu Jintao was the head of China, I had an opportunity to visit Shanghai, and I visited a Shanghai television company, and I noticed there was a Yoshimoto TV channel, and they were actually doing some shopping programs on it. Can you tell us what has happened to that channel? And can you tell us, with the anti-Japan feelings that are now so very strong in China, what is the situation for you in China?
ご質問ありがとうございます。ちょっと正確なあれなんですけど、15年ほど前に北京で、合弁の会社をというか、25% 吉本が出資した会社を作りました。中国娯楽発展有限コンスという、中国でのイベンターの会社です。天安門広場や万里の長城で、イベントをなさっている大きな会社です。で、当時は中国という国の名前がついた会社でエンターテインメントやってる会社に、日本吉本という外資の出資が入ってるっていうのは非常に珍しくって、多分最初で最後じゃないかと言われました。そういう会社が今もまああります。すると上海ではご存知のように上海メディアグループ SMG さんと 5、6 年ほど前に、合弁会社を作りました。テレビの番組の制作会社です。今も再開をしまして、週に一度日本の観光名所等々物産を紹介するような番組を、レギュラーでという言い方もおかしいんですが毎週放送しております。あと週末には大阪に大阪名物とまでおっしゃっていただけている吉本新喜劇というのがございますが、上海でも吉本上海新喜劇というドタバタコメディをやったりしております。その3つが今も継続をして、番組を制作をしたり一緒にコメディを作ったり、漫才の育成をしたりというのをやっております。ショッピングに関しては当社はまだやっておりません。ただ韓国の財閥やいろんなメディアの方が数年前からもちろん上海ではショッピングチャンネルをお持ちですごく儲かってんだというふうには聞いております。日本ではどの放送局もどの商社もまだ成立はできてないと思います。
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your question. すみません、すみません、上海の吉本新喜劇はあれは上海でなんとやってるんですか？やってるのかな、right.Thank you very much for your question. I don't remember precisely, but I believe it was about 15 years ago. We took part in the establishment of a joint venture in China, and Yoshimoto put 25% of the investment of this into the capital of this company. And the direct translation of the company name would be China Entertainment Development Company. Basically, it was an event.Organization, event-making organization. They would hold, they would prepare huge events in Tiananmen Square or on the Great Wall. We made a great deal of news at that time because the idea of having a foreign investor money, in other words, Yoshimoto Kogyo money, in a China entertainment company was considered to be very unusual. Many people said it would be the first and last time that such an investment could be made. In regard to your question about Shanghai, we still do have a relationship in Shanghai with a company called Shanghai Media Group, or SMG. 5 or 6 years ago, we again established a joint venture with them, basically to create television shows, produce television shows. Recently, we have been very active again with them. Once a week, we broadcast a program that introduces to audiences very famous tourist spots in Japan, and also different products, foods, stuffs, etc., and crafts, artistic objects that are produced in different locations throughout Japan. This is a regular broadcast once a week.And on the weekends, we have, as you may know, a theater in Osaka called the Shin Kigeki Theater. And this is basically new comedy theater. And what we do is we basically give the script to our Chinese counterparts, and they have their own Chinese version of the Osaka Yoshimoto Shin Kigeki, which is, again, broadcast on a regular basis. So it's a way for us to be able to sort of keep the manzai Japanese comic duo dialogue, stand-up comic duo dialogue form alive, and also to expand it to other areas as well. In regard to your comment about shopping, we've never been involved in a shopping program. We know that some Korean chaebols, some big companies and conglomerates have been doing some programs, shopping network programs in Shanghai, and they have made tremendous profits. However, up to this date, I don't think there's any Japanese broadcaster or trading company that has been successful in that area.
Okay, are there any other questions, or if anybody has a follow-up? Okay, I guess if there are no questions from the no more questions from the working press, we can expand it to other members as well. Oh, go ahead.
Yes, come my freelance. I'm concerned because...This project is partially funded by the government. And I believe any entertainment project influenced by Japanese government will fail. お国のお金がちょっと入ってるんで心配なんですけど、お役人さんが口出ししたらうまいこといかんと私は思います。どうやってお役人さんの、意見を聞かんようにするか、そんな方策があったら教えてください。
How will you keep the bureaucrats' voices from controlling your project. So how do you intend to fight back?
はい、あのですね、あの、まあ、クールジャパン機構さんと、のご支援をいただくということで、あの、いろいろと長い期間議論をさせていただいて、まあ、なあの我々が、エンターテインメントのプロであるということをご認識いただいて、基本的には事業の中身は、民間に任せますということをあのおっしゃっていただいてます。
In order for us to be able to receive the financial support of the Cool Japan Fund, we had a very, very long negotiating process. And during that time, we were able to gain the understanding of the Cool Japan Fund people that we are the professionals. So we have the professional expertise and knowledge in regard to the entertainment industry. And as a result, the contents of the entertainment projects should be left to ourselves.
あの、世にも珍しいケースで、あの、ご自由にお割りくださいと、私たちはあの後ろに回って協力に徹しますということをあのおっしゃっていただいたので、私たちが言う前からあの機構さんからそういうふうにおっしゃっていただいたので、あのすごくレアケースだと思います。それはあのすごくありがたいことですし、それに甘えてあの大事な国の税金を無駄遣いすることなく必ず、結果を出すということを頑張ろうと思っています。
As was explained, it's a very, very unusual stance that has been taken by the Cool Japan Fund by the government. I think it's a very, very unusual case in Japan that a bureaucrat would say, please do as you wish and we will just stand behind you and offer you whatever support you need. Their fundamental attitude was like that from the very beginning. Again, it's a very rare case, a very unusual situation, but we want to very much take advantage of this in the most positive way possible. We're very grateful and we have committed ourselves to ensuring that this project will be successful, that we will not waste valuable taxpayers' money, but ensure that the project does produce results.
Okay. Are there any other questions? Okay. If there aren't any other questions, again, I would like to thank our speakers today. As is our regular tradition, we would like to express our thanks by giving the speakers today honorary memberships for a year at the Press Club. And hopefully we might see you in the bar, maybe with some of your entertainers and musicians over the next year. Anyway, thank you very much. Thank you.